Dissecting the song.
Welcome back, everyone. We know we've been on a little bit of a hiatus.
Yep, emphasis on the high.
Yeah. You can see there's more hair on my crown.
Oh, which, let me see. Can I see your hair? Look. Well, that's pretty nice. Huh?
I went to Turkey for a few months to get a hair transplant.
Oh, really?
And it's been nice. I've been able to get a hair transplant because of the donations of kind viewers like you. Thank you. You might check our channel. It's on Beans and Rice. This is Dissecting the Song, where we interpret songs because you guys sometimes don't have the audacity to do so. You just enjoy the song. We enjoy it too, but we're doing the hard work for you guys. We have playlists for other things. You might see our main show. Beans and Rice is a comedy improv show. This is exclusive just for music.
Yeah. So if you want more of this, click on the playlist. So you might get a notification. Maybe you don't like longer format of videos, but you know, give us a chance on our other stuff too. It's pretty fun. But for you maniacs that like the music, Dissecting Your Song is a playlist. We have a couple of videos there, right?
Yeah, we've had a lot of great comments, so we appreciate the comments. We've had suggestions, and so far the strongest fan base has been the Lady Gaga fan base.
Oh yeah, well, thanks to the Lady Gaga fan base, we got a new set, like he said.
Yeah, you can see just a new area.
And look how nice the cat, after he listened to Lady Gaga, look at him.
Look at this.
You know?
Who's he going to kiss?
Gaga, Gaga, Gaga.
And that's the thing, we were suggested, I forget the name of the user, so I apologize.
You want to introduce yourself first?
Yeah, my name is Jose.
Okay, my name's Jose.
Yeah, and here, we have rules.
Yes.
We will be, again, listening to the song, dissecting it. When we need to pause so we can talk, someone will have to raise their hand, not me. I control the thing, the computer, so I can pause it whenever I please. I don't even have to pay attention to them, but I am because I'm
courteous. He's a nice
guy. We were advised to listen to Lady Gaga's Judas because we listened to, was it called Bloody Mary?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Bloody Mary, dude. Everybody's like, oh, you guys are wrong. People are telling us like the actual 10 things that it means, and then every comment, like just when you thought you had the lyrics figured out.
There's
from
a new
all the other
meaning.
Fans, like a new fan's like, oh no. Like one of the people's like, you know, she only said Bloody Mary 3 times during the whole song. I was
and
like,
that
what?
Tripped me out because I went back and listened to it. And yes, she only said Bloody Mary 3 times.
Yes. And that's when you say Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary.
And she appears in the mirror. But we're not looking in a mirror, so we're okay.
So that's like another meaning on top of all the other meanings she had on there, right?
And then she's talking about Mary Magdalene, is what we were told as well in the comments. So a lot of deep meaning behind a verbally limited song, which was fun. So we're anticipating a fun one here with Judas, because Mary Magdalene visited Jesus, or tried to at least, after he was killed in his tomb, and this is the guy that sent him to his tomb.
Yeah, and people are saying like, oh, I guess that Lady Gaga's like Catholic or something, you know? So people
I guess she's a devout Catholic. I don't know if she's like devout or she was Catholic.
Yeah,
but
she had beef with the priest, but
who knows?
Do you want to reveal the song that we're going to do today?
Absolutely. So today, the song that we're going, let me rewind the song because we were testing the audio, so we listened to the first like maybe 40 seconds of it. Let me reveal it on screen. And we have the lyrics up as well so that you guys can follow along and make sure that we're staying on topic. But it is Judas by Lady Gaga.
Yeah, I mean, it's 4 minutes looking at it. I mean, this one's probably going to be longer than Bloody Mary.
It might be.
Bloody Mary seemed like it went by kind of fast.
It felt fast, and we even discussed quite a bit. So I know we've already been talking quite a bit, so let's go ahead and just dive into the song. Hopefully you guys enjoy. Again, let us know in the comments what you think of our dissection. Is it correct or is it incorrect? Already great production. But I guess I don't expect anything less of someone like Gaga.
Satan's violin in the background. Can you hear it?
The distorted synth is nice. Yes.
Okay, I've noticed this on a lot of Lady Gaga songs. Like, every time she's singing about somebody else, then she always says her name at the end. Have you noticed?
Yeah, so, I mean, this is common in Puerto Rican music. They say their name in music. So maybe she's influenced by
Puerto
Ricans.
She might be Puerto Rican, Lady
Gaga? She might be. She might be.
What does Gaga mean in Puerto Rican?
Gaga is it's something a baby does. You know, Gaga. Because you
know? I noticed that she'll be like, I really like fast cars. I really like fast cars. Gaga, 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 Gaga. You know?
Oh, my. Mama, what's that song? I don't know the name of the song. I just sound like an idiot doing it, but she says Gaga on like every one of her
like
songs.
Yeah, like every song. Like,
yeah, like the rappers do too. You already know who it is. And then they say their name.
Yeah, but they don't really say to their mel whatever the song is.
They don't. Yeah, you're right. They don't part it as part of the lyrics in the song.
So, because already off the top, it's like, does she mean already that she's Judas?
She's incorporating her, or maybe she has tendencies of Judas.
Yeah, she's going, betrayal. Judas. And then it's like, Judas. Maybe she believes in reincarnation. Maybe she's Puerto Rican and Hindu.
Maybe. And she says, So when you say to a child,
you open.
You're telling them not to do something. Okay. So she says, Judas, Gaga. She's synonymous by being someone that says no, or she's doing something she shouldn't be.
Oh, she's tapping into our kid instinct.
Yes.
Oh, wow. That's pretty cool. That's all powerful, right. Huh?
I'm going to rewind it. Hold on. Yeah, I don't know if this is a two-way conversation now.
So is she saying, so Jesus is already in the cross? She said something about a three-way, now he's in the cross. Like, bring him down, like, maybe she sees Jesus. Because it's like talking about Jesus, you know, probably.
Yeah.
Didn't she betrayed him?
Didn't Judas hang himself afterwards anyways?
Oh, yeah, I think so, huh?
Yeah. And he betrayed him for 30 silver pieces.
He wanted to hang out.
Yeah, he was hanging around. he didn't want to hang around when he came back, though. So 30 silver gold pieces, or 30 silver gold, 30 silver pieces is what he sold him out for, right?
I don't know. Allegedly, we know. I don't
and
know.
They estimate that's roughly anywhere from like $250 to $300 in today's money.
Yeah, the currency.
So it's like, dude, that's like,
dude, you got about, dude,
for
rubles.
A pair of Jordans and some tax. And they called Jared his Aranus. Is that, I don't know.
Maybe.
Anyways, that has nothing to do with this song.
So you think they're saying let him down, like let Judas down, or let the Lord down?
No, maybe. I think they're letting the door. So she says, I'll clean your feet with my hair if I need to, right? That would be in reference. That's because Jesus would wash people's feet. That was his like way of giving back.
He was the original pedicurist, you know?
Yeah. And then there was this other thing that said, forgive him when his tongue lies through his brain. Is that when Jesus is on the cross telling Father, forgive them for they know not what they do? Here, hold on. If he needs, forgive him when his tongue lies through his brain. Even after three times he betrays me.
See, that's
because Judas betrayed him three times in different ways, right?
Did?
Like, isn't that was one of the... I'm not the greatest of Christians, obviously, right now, but there were three instances in which... Because the apostles fell asleep at him when he was at the Garden of...
Persephone.
Okay?
Oh, yeah, baby. I know that one. I went to church school for 5 years,
at the Garden of Gethsemane. They fell asleep, so that was like a form of betrayal. Like, he trusted them. And there were two other times, I think, that happened where the apostles, Judas being an apostle, they betrayed him. They betrayed Jesus in the sense that they didn't do what they were supposed to.
So when they say the 12 apostles, was there originally 13, or he was one of the 12?
No, he was one of the 12.
Oh, really?
It's 12, and that's why the jury is always a 12. It's symbolic of apostles.
But wouldn't it be bad, because 12, he wasn't really an apostle. So would you take Judas off, how many?
It would be 11.
11? 11 is what number?
1-1.
The holy number, right? 11-11?
Yeah. So you're right. Maybe 11 is the best number. So
it's the best number.
The judicial system is corrupt.
Yes, there's a Judas in there.
Oh, my God.
Nancy Pelosi.
She's got two big 11s on her chest. So she's in love with Judas?
I think so.
Oh, oh, I'm in love with Judas, Judas. Oh, 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 oh. I like this distorted part right here. It's really cool. Pure relief.
I didn't understand anything.
I was trying to interpret, and the more I heard and read, the more it shifted. But she mentioned you could sink a body. Mafia people, how do they sink bodies?
They put a rock.
A brick, essentially, like a cedar block, or what, cinder blocks.
Cinder block.
She mentioned the house, building a house. How do you build houses? Bricks, cinder blocks.
Mexican.
So by the same way you build something up, it can be torn down. By the same thing. Right?
You can throw bricks at a house, you're saying?
Yeah, like, think of a cornerstone, like a keystone, where you have something, and the keystone holds the whole arch together, right? It's one single stone.
Oh.
Remove the stone, and it collapses
and
upon itself.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
So I guess it's symbolic of the importance of one crown, and Jesus is your rock. Jesus can be your cinder block. And if you don't have Jesus, you bring him down, the whole thing collapses.
But she's saying she's in love even though he's a fool or something like that? Wasn't she?
Yeah, and it did say that the prophets forgave him.
So she's saying she likes him
forgive him
he
for
takes
his goofy
chances,
way.
Basically? Like, even though he's like an idiot?
Maybe.
She still likes that he's a risk taker.
Yeah.
She, I guess, and, admires that part about him.
And this is the other part, right? This is the difficult part of the conversation where Adam, the fall of Adam led to mankind.
Yeah.
Right? So essentially, the transgression of Eve led to the transgression of Adam that allowed humans to come about.
Come on.
Without Judas, do we get salvation? Because then Jesus wouldn't have been crucified. Is that what it, like, you know what I mean? And that's why this is a king with no crown, king with no crown.
Wow.
Jesus is the King of Kings.
So he gets all the credit, but dude, Judas did it.
Judas was at least 50%, because Jesus was 50% of being crucified for our sins and died for our sins.
But
while
Judas,
he would not have
crucified.
Done it. And that's where maybe the cornerstone comes into play, right?
Yeah.
He's such an essential piece that if he didn't do that, the fall of mankind stays.
This
but now
like
we have the option to use that cornerstone to build, or the keystone to build.
This is like one of the Lady Gaga. She's kind of like JC when she said, "You respect the man who got shot. I respect the shooter."
Yep.
So Lady Gaga, she respects the shooter.
She respects the shooter.
You know?
Loves him a little bit too much, maybe, but she respects him nonetheless.
Wow,
it's
cool.
A good song, though. Yeah. I like it. Super catchy as always.
I want to say Gaga.
She say it a little bit when they go Judah.
I like when she says that.
She didn't do it this time. I'm sure she'll end this way. I'll be upset if she doesn't.
Ew. Ew.
This may be when Jesus walking through the thing. But in the cultural sense, I just speak in future tense. Judas is me a offense to where it comes in next time. We're gonna go back to that. Yeah. See,
this sounded like, is she
dude,
talking
so
about
lost.
Modern day whores?
What was she saying in the last?
Okay, so we'll pause as we go around. In the most biblical sense, I am beyond repentance. The Bible always does predict that the fall of humans will.
So would, she's saying she's a lost cause? Is that what she's saying?
In the most biblical sense, I am beyond repentance.
Like, she's already repented so much. It's like, you can't.
She's to a point in her life she can't repent.
Yeah, it's like beyond repentance. Like, what's going to happen? The Lord's already Lady Gaga. Come on. I am beyond repentance.
wench vomits her mind. Yeah. Fame hooker, prostitute, wench vomits her mind.
Maybe she's saying, so she's famous?
She's a famous hooker, prostitute. So obviously sexual sins is very, very frowned upon. Vomits her mind, what, speaks her mind? She just says what she wants?
So is she saying she's a whore for the fame, and she's famous because she just spews out her thoughts?
Yes.
So she's saying, like, even though maybe she might be a good person because she's doing all of this, she's basically a prostitute, prostituting her own thoughts, so she's still sinning in some way?
Yeah, I guess. But in the cultural sense, I just speak in future tense. I guess let me finish this. Tense, I just speak in future tense. Judas is me a good if offensed, or wear ear condom next time. God, what is this?
So I think meaning? Maybe she's saying that. So, okay, so in the biblical thing, she's a whore. She's just getting fame. She's getting money. But now in current times, she's just basically like an icon.
But in the cultural sense, right? I just speak in future tense.
So she's just ahead of her time. She's like a goal. She's a really good artist.
So I guess people can betray her in the sense that they... It makes her a martyr. The hate makes her a martyr and only makes her that much more glorified and holy to her fans. Or we're a condom next time, like, don't pay attention to me. Like the, what do they call it? Like Romans, the people that ignored Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Like, so either way, she's the savior of music. Is that what she's saying?
Yeah, she's saying, like, either way, like, Judas, kind of like to your point, how you were saying, like, you they wouldn't have crucified Jesus or the story wouldn't have been completed without him.
Yeah, everything, like...
So is he a good guy or a bad guy? So it's like the same with her. Is she a good girl or a bad girl?
Yeah, but it doesn't matter even in that sense, because regardless of it, she is the savior. That's how I'm taking it in regards to this music. It's like someone can betray her and it in the future sense, right? She's like in biblical tense.
Well, she is just saying like in the future, like as of now. So she's comparing herself to biblical times. Like, yeah, she's a prostitute, she's a whore because she's getting attention, she's doing all these things, but in present time, she's ahead of her time.
Yeah.
Kind of like a Kanye West when everybody's like, oh, well, Lady Gaga, she's so cool, she's ahead of her time, she's, like, prolific, she's all these things. So she's like, in current times, they see me as this, but if they were to put me in older times perspective...
She'd be a prophet.
No, in older times, I'd be a piece of shit.
Oh,
but right okay. Now, in the current times, you think of me as a prophet.
Because
I'm being, you know what I mean? Like, I'm futuristic. Like, I'm prophesizing things. I'm ahead of my time. So, as of right now, they don't even see her as.
So, is that why she loved Judas? Because Judas is the catalyst to her being essentially a savior?
Something like that, you know?
Because that's why she loves Judas, maybe? I don't know.
She sees a similarity.
Yeah, you have.
She's seeing the similarity of, like, so she's like Judas when you see the bad things of Judas, but then, like, you were pointing out
that it had to happen.
Yep. So, it's like with her, it's like. In biblical sense, she's like a piece of shit. In current times, so like now maybe in current times, if you see Judas, you might see it to your perspective, right?
Yeah.
So like with her.
Because we have perspective.
Yes. So maybe now when she's dead, like, oh, maybe this is what she meant.
Yeah.
Because she was so ahead of her time. I wanna love you, but something's pulling me away from she's you. Repenting. Jesus, see her? Is my virtue.
And Jesus is the demon I cling to. Figured it out.
Yeah, that's what happened?
I think so.
Come on, let's go.
Look at this, Gaga fans. You guys had us in a corner for a little bit.
Let's do it right here on top so they can see us, okay?
Still in love with Judas, baby. Oh, I'm in love. Judas.
There we go. She finally did it at the end.
Yeah, finally we got it done. Sorry, that's another song that just kind of queued up. But let us know if we got it right. That was a tough one, though.
Yeah, dude, that's... And then they're going to tell us in the comments, oh,
that we still got it wrong.
She only said Judas two times. Yeah. I was like... know?
Yeah, because Judah doesn't count. You know, Judah. She didn't say Judas. She said Judah.
Yeah.
So.
Damn, but dude, these songs.
They're fun.
Yeah, because this is the second Lady Gaga song that we've listened to. We don't listen to Lady Gaga, guys. You know, it's only for these reactions, and they're kind of cool. They're especially when you like slow down and look at them.
Well, especially when you think of the genre that they're in, right? Pop isn't. I personally don't think that pop. I think unanimously, it's ubiquitously just shallow music, right?
Yeah,
it's not meant to be super deep. And we saw with the not the Wednesday song, the Bloody Mary song.
Bloody Mary, yeah.
That it was. Very, very symbolic and had
even
a lot
though
of
it was so simple.
Metaphors. Yeah.
This one was more complicated, I feel like.
I definitely feel this one was more complicated, yeah. But
it was still simple.
Yeah.
But it has like way more depth in a weird way.
It's definitely a heavy topic. So you guys let us know in the comments.
Yeah.
What other Lady Gaga songs you guys want us to listen to? Because again, so far Lady Gaga's fan you guys have been very kind.
Yeah.
Just you guys have a lot of good things to say too. So it's been really cool to yes.
I do have a question for the Lady Gaga fans. Do you guys get mad at people that say, oh, I'm a Lady Gaga fan, but that they don't understand the lyrics? I wonder if they're like, oh, that's a Lady Gaga casual.
Yeah.
You know, like if they don't understand that there's so much depth to the lyrics, they're like, dude.
Yeah, let us know. Do you guys shun those that don't really understand the true meaning of Gaga lyrics? Because sometimes that happens in the hip-hop community.
Yeah.
So we want to know, does that extend into the pop culture?
The pop community.
The pop
the
music.
Gaga community.
Yeah. The God. Yeah. Okay. You know, but thank you guys for tuning in on this episode of
Dissecting
the Song. We promise we will be providing more dissections
as
the time goes by. We just took a little hiatus. We had other things going on. Again, hair transplant. Things have gone great. Thank you. We'll catch you on the next episode of Dissecting the Song.
Hasta luego.